You remember your childhood days when you used to play cricket? It was not that you started by reading a book. You actually took a bat in your hand and, you know, started simply hitting balls with it. Same way we will be learning programming, by doing it. Although to learn Python, you need to install a lot of things in your computer. You need to install the Python interpreter. You need to learn about the console. You need to have an editor. But to make learning very easy for you, within Newton School portal, we have brought about this entire development environment to teach you and help you get started with Python very easily. So come, let's get started. To get started, open up the Newton School website. The URL is www.newtonschool.co. You can, you know, copy paste it from here. Just observe it. We have also provided the link in the description box. You know, if you see over here, there are many things, you know, about our courses, about, you know, our competition, many other things. For now, just focus on the login and sign up part. Click here and you will be taken to a registration page to sign up. Now just fill out all the details about on this page and, you know, you'll get into a portal. Once you've logged into the portal, you will see something like this. Okay, so this is the main page of the portal. There are two tabs over here. One is the tracks and the other is playground. If you go into the tracks part, for most of you, it would be empty. There are other, you know, tracks which you can enroll into. For example, you know, the coding challenge, or there's a free Java course that you can enroll into. So all these things are available over here. But for you, the focus area should be the playground. Click on the playground tab and there you will see two options. One is the markup playground, which is basically for creating website, that is HTML, CSS, JavaScript. This is not of going to be used in this course. If you want, you can explore it. Like other things, it's completely free. You need to go down and you need to see an algorithm playground over here. Okay. And what you can do is basically you can create your own playground over here. So what does playground means? We call our entire setup, you know, in which you can create code, provide input, see output as a playground. It's Newton School playground. So you can come over here and create a playground. You can create a playground, you know, just by typing any name over here. Let me just start with, you know, Python tutorial one, learning Python from scratch. Once you create it, it will get opened up and you will see an interface something like this. Over here, you can see different sections. In this part, the code, that is the actual code that we are going to write, will go over here. Here you can see different languages. We have provided many, many languages on which you can practice, but for now we have to just concern ourselves with Python. You can go down here and somewhere you will find Python 3.6, just like this. And basically this is the section where we'll be writing our code. This is the section where we'll be providing input. It won't be used in the first class, but eventually for all the assignments and all, you're going to extensively use this section. This is the part where you'll get the output. The output that a program produces, and it is going to be all text, will be printed over here. You can see if you've got any error or any other kind of warning in these different tabs within the output section. You can see the std error. This will give you any kind of error. Compile output, if there's any compilation error, it will be given over here. And the same with the message. Any other message will be provided over here. To run the program, you need to click on the run button. And to save it, you need to click on the save button. So that's all about it. Let's just begin with writing our first code. In programming, usually there's a practice to write a program called Hello World, which just prints out Hello World, you know, and that is usually the first program that you write. Let's just, you know, do it. In Python, what you need to do is you need to write print. And as it must have been explicit, print does nothing but just prints out whatever you give it to. You'll have to put in brackets. I'll explain all these syntax and you'll have to write a string called Hello World. And let's just click on run. As you can see in the output, you have gotten a Hello World over here. Just save it, and now the playground has been saved. One important thing over here is, you know, in coding, one of the things that is going to be really helpful to you is, instead of just simply copy pasting code, if you want to learn something, see it and type it on your own. You will learn it much better. So just go ahead, create your own playground, and just type this code out in your own playground and run it. So that was for the first class. In the next class, you'll be learning about variables, different data types. You'll also learn how to operate on them, you know, and do various kind of mathematical and arithmetic operations on them. And stay tuned. If you really like this video, do make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and share it with friends who would like to learn Python from the very basics.